A raging wildfire that tears right through a house. Fortunately, the one that you are about to see unfold, there's Jonathan Serrie as they watch this unbelievable thing happen, is simulated. It's the work of an insurance institute, for Business and Home Safety Research Center, testing the effects of fire on different building materials, hoping that they can learn from that and hopefully save lives and property. Jonathan Serrie is pretty close to it all there. It might be getting a little warm where he is in Richburg, South Carolina. Hey there, Jonathan.
Hey, Martha, it actually is getting a little warm. Even through this glass, I can feel the intense heat. You can see the home right now. It's on a turntable. They're gradually turning it around so everyone can get a good view of how the fire is impacting this particular home. What they're doing here is trying to illustrate how wildfires impact residential areas. A common misperception is that the wildfire itself, the flames themselves, go over these homes and residential areas and do most of the damage, but actually that's incorrect. Actually, when the wildfires reach large residential areas, the streets and relative lack of trees keep the flames at bay, but burning embers from those flames get caught up in the wind, are blown onto rooftops, blown onto dry vegetation near homes, and that's what ultimately sets fire to the home. Right now, you're looking inside a giant wind tunnel. It's able to simulate hurricane force winds, but today it's only blowing 10 mile an hour winds, but they're launching burning embers into these very gentle winds. And that, as you can see, within a short period of time, just a few minutes, was able to set fire to the exterior of this life-size house. Portions on the roof have caught fire. On the roof, there were also dry pine needles that caught fire. Also, simulated vegetation around the perimeter of the house has caught fire. And this is what happens in the real world. And so the Insurance Institute for Business and Home Safety is hoping that this demonstration will help homeowners come up with relatively simple ways to harden their homes against wildfires if they live in these wildfire-prone areas. Martha?
I mean, you can see for one thing, you were talking about the pine needles on the roof and the vegetation around. We all remember the images of people watering down some of those areas, but certainly keeping that stuff off your roof if you're in that danger zone looks like it's a very good idea, Jonathan.
Indeed, some of the simplest measures can harden your house against wildfires. In many cases, it's just keeping your roof clear of debris, dry leaves, dry pine needles. Also using materials that are flame resistant in your roofing materials. In other cases, it's either moving some of the shrubs involved with your landscaping away from the perimeter of the house, or if you have shrubs near the house, keeping them trimmed so that any dry and dead material is kept well away from the exterior walls of the house.
Yeah.